glass hedgehog and he comes out. He loves it.
This came for you.
Really? What is it?
Not sure.
Great, new cereal.
Oh, baby, I like it.
All right, Noel, did you get my package?
Yeah, yeah, just eating them now. Pretty good, actually.
Yeah, they're called secret pieces. They're good, ain't they?
Remarkable. What are they made from?
That's my own shit.
Well, Peter.
No, I mean, that's my multicoloured rabbit droppings. Like, I go into a chamber and I eat, like, loads of vitamins and pieces of rainbow. I make rainbow kebabs and they spin round and I slice bits of rainbow, I put it in pita bread and then I munch it down till like, I'm big and fat and ready. And then I just pump them out through my blue shorts straight into the packets. I can do like 7 packets a week.
Actually, I'm very Moorish.
That'll be the nicotine. When I first made them, they looked like hundreds and thousands, but more swollen. So I called them 10s and 20s. And I was going to use them as cake decoration. So like, I phoned up Mr. Kipperbang, you know, the cake doctor. And he said, go fuck yourself. But, you know, I think they go better with milk anyway.
Are they in the shops then?
No, but they're outside the shops by the bush.
Yeah, all right, see that, Peter.
Yeah, nice one. Don't call me again, yeah?
You have 3 minutes until takeoff and 2.5 minutes to prepare your main course. I will see you in the holding pattern. Good luck and God bless America. Clickety click. The Lord, the boy can see.
Chop, chop, chop!
Just look at the size of that carrot! Put a little whiskey in that, will you, Rodriguez? Oh, boy! I think I'm one of them lizard people. Harold Faltemeyer, disguised as an octopus, blowing a whistle, reminding you you're fresh out of goddamn paprika. Rodriguez, put a shot of bourbon in that, will you?
Gentlemen, you have 15
seconds to board your vessel.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Perfect job, Patriots!
I'm the moon. I'm not in the show.
No class, I do not cycle home like Miss Kite, and I haven't got a snazzy car like Mr. Empton, and I will not get on the bus with you horrible little lot. I ride the pommel horse home like every PE teacher should. That's a little joke for the tiny ones. You see, I can be a character like Mr. Clansby, I just need a chance to shine.
All right, Peter.
Hey, Noel, who's the best film star who ever lived?
Kurt Russell.
Yeah, what's the best film that's ever been made?
Big Trouble in Little China.
I told you, Nathan, you idiot. I gotta go, Noel, I'm in the pub.
Yeah, great.
I'm Sergeant Raymond Boombox. As you may or may not know, in 1975, I received a knife wound in the line of duty. A knife wound that started talking to me and occasionally helped me solve cases.
Helped you on some of your cases? I solved most of them, you fat son of a bitch!
Shut up, you freak. Trying to put you in some kind of goddamn context. Anyway, one of the most exciting cases we worked on was when we were in Miami undercover. Hooper, what was the name of that case?
What do you mean, the one where you're wearing the pink salmon shorts? You look ridiculous, you big fat pumpkin ass sticking out.
You picked those out for me! What were you wearing anyway, your wife's skirt?
It was a sarong, actually, and it was your wife's.
You do not have access to my wife's sarong collection. You mind your mouth.
Ah, of course he did. He was banging her. Everyone knows that.
He was not banging her. They just happened to be at the same night school doing the same dance classes.
Yeah, we were doing modern tap and urban hip-hop.
Precisely. Thank you, Hooper. You be quiet. Anyway, we were down in Miami and I looked like one piece of hot ass. We'd offloaded some drugs to a known local dealer called Figo the Fruit Fly. Name so, because everything he landed on turned rotten. All we had to do was get a payment off this guy and we could bust his thorax. Working with these scumbags was absolutely terrifying. If they even sniffed you out as a cop, not only would they kill you, but they could make things very awkward for you. It didn't bother me. I was a frightening mimic. An unbelievable actor, like a slightly hairier Kirk Douglas without the deformed chin. I could slot in with these guys as soon as look at them. Speak the lingo. I was one of them.
Yo, I gave you the money. What say you give me the drugs? Go out and get a couple of chicks and a couple of beers.
Do you take cats?
What?
Do you take cats?
Ah, that's no better. Try it slower or faster.
You take cats.
Jesus Christ, that's not helping anything. Put your eyes away. What are you saying to me?
Do you take cards?
He's saying, do you take a card?
Do I take cards? Of course I don't take cards. What do I look like, a cash machine?
I do. Sir, put your card in my mouth and I'll be happy to handle your transaction.
What the hell are you doing?
Shut up! Would you like a receipt for that, sir?
Yeah, please.
So the goddamn gash ate Figo's card. Needless to say, he was not a happy bunny. He produced the Norman sword and slashed me across the belly pouch with the speed and agility of a NASA cyborg.
Oh my God! What's wrong with you? What are you, a reenactment?
Because of the gash, the whole drug bust went tits up. And things went from bad to worse.
Oh my God, somebody call an ambulance. This guy's in trouble.
Oh, really? What do you know? You a doctor?
No, I am not a doctor, thank you very much, but my brother-in-law happens to be one, so we've been around a lot of accidents, okay?
Oh, as if you're married. You just appeared there on a fat guy's gut.
Could you try not to insult me while you're insulting someone else? If you hadn't eaten the card in the first place, we wouldn't be in this mess.
But it was so good. It was Lloyd's flavor.
Oh my God, it was so not Lloyd's flavor. It was Barclays.
It's Barclays, not Barclays, you goddamn schmuck.
Oh, Barclays, Barclays, bite me.
Oh, for God's sake, somebody call me an ambulance. Use your phone.
I can't. I got no battery.
Well, use your phone then.
I can't help you. I got no signal.
Fine, I call my own goddamn ambulance. I can hear the ambulance. We're gonna be fine.
Oh, great. Very funny.
Sorry, Sarge. I got a gift for mimicking different types of emergency siren.
Well, good luck on new faces. I'm bleeding to death here if you haven't noticed.
Okay. Does anyone want to hear my impersonation of Michael Caine?
No, we do not want to hear your impersonation of Michael Caine. Shut up.
You're a big man, but you're out of shape.
And so Figo got away with the drugs. I had to crawl on my goddamn hands and knees to the hospital. But they fixed me up good, and we decided to stay on in Miami for a week's holiday. Me and the gash got loaded on cocktails, and poor Hooper was mistaken in his sarong for a lady of the night. Oh, how we laughed when he was almost gangbanged by 15 sailors. I laughed so hard, I burst open my tummy stitches, and my tummy gashed, regaled the whole party with his impersonations of Michael Caine and Harry Dean Stanton. A fabulous holiday, and one I'll always remember. Join me next week, and remember, always keep a knife under your bed, because most people are murdered by the person they love the most. And I look at a lot of corpses, and most of those corpses have been violated and raped before they've been murdered. So, at least a screwdriver. I mean, it's your choice.
Bye bye, everyone!
Good night. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. Yeah, all bleeding coming together, isn't it? All bleeding coming together. Oh, it's all bleeding coming together. What a place. Cap, you couldn't get bored, could you? How could you get bored? You can go around this. You can go around a pointed rock. Look at this. I've got a tire on a rope. Tire on a bleeding rope. Who came up with that? Who could come up with that? Higher, lower, I'm in a zoo. All bleating coming together. Great food. Top flight food. Got to be a gourmet chef, innit? Got to be a gourmet chef, innit? Who's your Ed Ramsay? Oh, Warren Thompson. Got to be, innit? Nice food. Not that hungry, might have that later. David Lee Roth, King of the Lions. You're right, David. We'll have that later. Yeah, there he is. Had a little operation when I got here. They took my penis away, removed my penis. Probably having a look at it, aren't they? Probably having a look at my penis. Gonna get it back, aren't I? They're bound to give it back to me. Probably Thursday. I mean, they're probably doing a diagram of it or something for a zoology book. John, any news on my penis? What a card. He always does that. Oh, I love it. English sense of humour. English sense of humour. I mean, I'd read about it and I'd heard about it, but I'd never actually seen it with my own lion peepers. Peepers. I called my eyes peepers. That's because I'm happy. I'm happy with my environment. I love it here. All bleating coming together. I'm in a zoo. All bleating coming together. Higher, lower, higher, lower. Let me out! Let me out! It is all bleating coming together, isn't it? Please say it's bleating coming together. I can't handle it anymore. I'm going crazy. Oh, you gotta help me! Don't just film me! Help me! Sit down and have some hula hoops, David. David, you're not chewing them properly, David. What's wrong with you? They're just going on the floor! I love you, David. You're king of the lions. I'm moving stuff about in here, John. I'm having a brain snap. Oh, treading on my lunch. It's gone everywhere. I asked for quavers. In you go. Oh. What, are you putting that in a frame? Yeah, of course I'm putting it in a frame. It's a masterpiece. What would you do with it?
I'd probably just blue tack it to the fridge door. What is it anyway?
Do you mean what is it? It's Pele, but he's holding a china teacup.
Oh yeah, actually it has got something.
You see, it's enigmatic. It's like the Mona Lisa, you know? It's the eternal question. Is she a woman? Is she a man? Is she smiling? Isn't she smiling? This throws up similar sort of questions.
What questions?
Well, it's Pele. He's holding a china cup. That much is clear. But when you come down his leg to the little tippy toe of his boot and you see this, what is that?
The ball.
But is it the ball? Or is it the saucer for the cup?
Oh yeah, this changes everything. I've got to phone Trisha.
Yeah,
in the event of losing a loved one. Some people will turn to therapy to help them through hard times. Other people might turn to religion, weaker people. I myself, when I lost my wife, turned to swing ball. You see, we used to play tennis together and I tried to recreate those hours by wearing my wife's dress and playing myself in the garden. It wasn't really the same. My wife has left me and gone to heaven. My wife has left me and gone to heaven. My wife has left me and gone to heaven. My wife has left me and gone to heaven. I've got a swing full blues. 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 Not a bad tune. I've got a swing full blues. I got Sweet Full Blues, produced by Dr. Dre. Got Sweet Full Blues, you got Sweet Full Blues. Left, right, no, yes, no means yes. Left, right, no means yes. Got Sweet Full Blues, I got a Sweet Full Blues. I got a Sweet Full Blues, the bleep Sweet Full Blues. I'll be king of my packet. I'll be king of my packet. I'll be king of my packet. I'm the king of my own packet. I'm the king of my own packet. It cuts Roy circles. He's got chocolate ankles. Oh, last Thursday I woke up on my own and there was blood in my pants.
I mean, I look at it and I think, I don't really like your drawings, but this one has something. And I wonder why I keep coming back to it, why I'm so drawn to it. It's Pele holding a China cup. I like it, it's clear, it's direct. But then my eye travels down past his midriff to his boots. I notice the ball, and then it hits me like a thunderbolt. Is it a ball, or is it the saucer for the cup?
Exactly.
I didn't know you were so deep and complicated, Noel.
I'm usually not, but when I do my felt tip drawings, that's when I get pretty deep, but yeah.
How much do you think a drawing like this is worth on today's market?
I'm getting it valued later, actually, by Darren Cash.
Who's Darren Cash?
He invented the colouring pencil. He's on his way as we speak.
I'm burning.
You are an idiot.
What do you mean?
Well, you live with one of the most famous artists of the 20th century, an icon, Andy Warhol.
Not him, he's an idiot. He's my cleaner. I suppose I could ask him.
Andy! Look at this.
A coloured diagram. How quaint.
Not a coloured diagram, is it? It's a masterpiece.
Let me take a closer look.
What are you doing?
Looking. I see Pele, a footballer, holding a China cup, which is slightly interesting, but does not tell me anything I do not know already.
What do you mean?
You have drawn a footballer, kicking a football. This is a standard observation.
Yeah, but is it a football?
What do you mean?
Or is it the saucer for the cup?
Oh my God, you have blown Andy's mind! So, Andy, what do you think it's worth?
Saucer, cup, saucer, cup, saucer, cup, Pele, Pele, score a goal, Pele, saucer, cup, saucer, cup, saucer, ball.
Moriarty's revenge. The smell of beer wafted through the narrow cobbled streets, the fog thick and clinging to the passing stagecoaches. Dr. Watson checked his new pocket watch and shuffled through a concrete archway.
Well, Noel, to be honest, it is impossible to put a figure on a drawing like that. It is priceless. Ashtray.
Wow, so you think you might be interested in buying it then?
No, but if you want any free colouring pencils, give me a call.
It's a bit racy, isn't it?
Yes. It is my aim to make colouring pencils sexy again.
Again?
Mm-hmm.
Amazing! You've got a tank made from Swiss cheese.
This tank is not made out of Swiss cheese, it's made out of ordinary cheese.
What are those holes then?
Those, my friend, are the injuries of war. I don't expect a civilian punk like you to know the difference. Right then, up ahead, a pencil drawing of Pele, done in a naive, primitive style. He's holding a china teacup, an obvious slant towards surrealism. But as we all know, you should never take crockery onto the playing field. When little Stephen Cahilly, the Kenyan boy, tried to do cross-country with a teapot in his shorts, Darren Cooper tripped him up and his winkle came loose. A nightmare. I had to carry that to hospital in a matchbox. I'll never get over those images. All in all, though, not a bad little drawing. Wait a second. If I'm not mistaken, the body has been done in freehand, but the head has been traced.
The head has not been traced, thank you very much.
Tracing? Tracing! As we all know, Mrs. Kite, the head of the art department, does not see tracing as real drawing. Therefore, this Karen Dash abomination must be taken as the enemy. Right then, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are numbers. Ignore those and fire!
Hello!
Violence, just like on the battlefield when I was young. Erections everywhere.
Pele! Pele, come back! Please, Pele, you don't understand. I've had an offer from Darren Cash. Well, not an offer, but he gave me his business card. Pretty racy, actually. Pele, please! Pele, don't leave me!
He's good at running, isn't he?
Yeah, he's great at running. He's gone now forever. That was my masterpiece. Hang on a minute. There he is down there in the jungle, look. Oh, look at him weaving in and out of the bracken. He's so balletic. He hasn't spilled a drop of that tea.
Oh, look, he's gone right down to the corner flag.
Pele, cross it! Pele!
Oh, it was a saucer.
Or was it?
There's more gloriously weird stuff straight out of Noel's head, same time next week. Next tonight, another Chris Moyles quiz night thingy.